after simulating your entire system in the simulator, okay, your simulator is giving some response, then after fabrication, if results are different, then what is the use? Suppose if you want to develop a full adder, my full adder specifications are like, I need a very low power full adder, I need a very high speed full adder. The speed will be in the form of something like delay will be in the form of something 1 picoseconds delay should be there, and again power will be something like 1 nanowatt. Okay, this is the specification. Okay, then in the simulator we got the specifications, we got very low power, and we got designed the full adder with the very low power and again very high speed. But after fabrication, what happened? After fabrication, then the fabrication full adder, fabricated full adder IC is not meeting the specifications. Then there is no use. There is no use of the corresponding full adder. Then the problem is there, right? The full adder uses some devices. Those devices are having inaccurate model files. If model file is accurate, then the simulation results and the fabricated results will be correct. The beauty is here, these Synopsys and Cadence tools, okay, they have their own research team to develop accurate model files. When device model file is accurate, then only the simulation results and fabricated results will be same. Are you getting? Means our main intention is our actual device, physical device, and the model file results should be same. Okay, means we try to develop any model to accurately describe the behavior of the device under all possible conditions. Means our model file should be very, very accurate. The quality of simulation is decided by the performance of models. Your model should give very good accuracy, and again it should take very less computation time. I told you simple MOSFET first order current equation is ID equal to something I have told you just now. That is a first order current equation where we have ignored many parasitic components, where we have ignored many leakage current effects. Okay, the corresponding current equation is not valid for the nowadays nanometer designs. Even for your first year lab also, okay, in basic electronics lab, okay, or otherwise your EDC lab, okay, your on current whatever you have developed mathematically and the practical results, they never match. Practically whatever you use using your oscilloscope, okay, those results and the mathematical equations, they never match, because to develop this mathematical equation ID equal to I naught into e power v by theta vt minus 1, we have ignored many parameters. Okay, that is the reason these mathematical results and the actual results, they never match. But our main intention is the mathematical equation, or otherwise mathematical model, should be more accurate. For that, we try to include as many number of variables as possible, such that our model should be accurate with respect to the physical device. Means we try to compromise with the accuracy and computation time. I told you simple diode current equation, and again the simple MOSFET current equation, where the MOSFET current equation is very simple, but the actual current MOSFET equation model file needs couple of hundreds of variables, because we have to include about the many parasitic components like resistors, capacitors, inductors, effect will be there, unwanted leakage currents effect will be there. If we include all those parameters, your MOSFET model file will be accurate. At the same time, to run the corresponding MOSFET file where hundreds of variables are there, it takes more time. The basic problem is here, if you develop a model file which is very accurate, but I told you just now, on an IC paper we are having millions of transistors with hundreds of model file mathematical values variables, okay, that needs more time for the simulation. That is the reason the current processor, the simulation testing time is couple of days. If testing the corresponding processor, if it takes more time, then the time to market will be more. We want our model file should be accurate, at the same time it should be computationally efficient. Means our testing should run in a shorter time, at the same time our result should be accurate. And circuit simulators have great demand for new device and interconnect models, mainly for the full custom designs. Do you know the difference between the full custom design and semi-custom design? Have you heard semi-custom and full custom? Semi-custom design means the corresponding design can be developed using the existing devices. Existing devices like MOSFET, BJT, those are used to develop the corresponding design. Whereas full custom design example is high performance processors. Very high performance processors. Okay. Means the corresponding processor is not available in the market. When the corresponding processor is not available in the market, okay, I'll tell you a simple example of full adder. If you need a full adder with huge specifications like it has to be very faster and it should take very less power dissipation, and the corresponding full adder IC is not available in the market. Means that is the order we are getting. Something like nowadays we need mobile phones where we need 5G data, isn't it? And again, our processor has to run very fast, faster way. Means we need every year we want new mobile phones with very good features. In that case, we need high performance processors. For high performance processors, with the existing MOSFETs, existing interconnects, it is not possible. To develop any high performance processor, those corresponding processors are not available in the market, means industry people, they have to start from the scratch. Scratch indicates that people have to develop innovative materials they have to use, and innovative devices they have to use. I told you, full custom means the corresponding design is not available in the market. The corresponding processor is not available in the market. Means very high performance operations. In that case, existing devices are not useful. Then they should develop new devices, like new tunnel bit devices, new pin fed devices, or otherwise some spin garnet devices, or otherwise some additional hybrid devices. Okay, using those devices, we can get. There is no guarantee. Any full custom design, there is no guarantee, because people, they start with new materials, new combination of materials, new gate engineering, new band gap engineering they use, okay, in such a way that they develop new device. Basically, any device is a combination of layers only, different layers only. MOSFET means we need metal layer, oxide layer, substrate is there, source and drains are there, isn't it? Couple of layers only with different materials, okay. I told you, with existing MOSFETs and existing CAD tools with existing available MOSFET models, we are not getting the full custom design parameters. For that, we should start with the scratch. Means we should develop new devices, new materials. For those new devices, we should develop new model files also. We should develop new model files. Those new model files we have to integrate. We have to integrate into the library. Then the corresponding new devices, again we have to start from the scratch. Again we should develop inverter and couple of gates, and we should test it. And till we reach the target specifications, we will be simulating. And after fabrication, there is no guarantee of getting the required specifications. That is the reason full custom design needs lot of efforts. It's a multi-billion task, because full custom designs are not available with the existing fabrication process also. For full custom designs, people need different fabrication setup, because the MOSFET fabrication process is different, and the FinFET fabrication process is different. In future, if you are going for some new device, means after 10 years, some new devices means, for new device, we need separate fabrication process. When we need separate fabrication process, means it needs lot of efforts, because the fabrication in India is delayed, because it needs lot of money. Because only the foreign countries, Taiwan and even USA, China, means they are having the fabrication setups, okay. Because those fabrication process needs lot of money, and again huge efforts also, and again every every generation, like as per Moore's law, when we try to integrate more number of devices, means the MOSFET models will change. Why MOSFET models will change means the long channel MOSFET model is different and the short channel MOSFET model is different. Because every MOSFET, when we are shrinking the dimensions, we are having extra physics, means we are having extra leakage currents are there. We have to include those parameters in the model drive. That is the reason, some setting from 1 micrometer device to the current 10 nanometer device, we need different MOSFETs, different MOSFET model drives we need. And again when we go for the new devices means new model drives we need. Okay, there is a lot of demand for developing new devices with new model files. Those should be integrated with the CAD tools, and after that there is no guarantee that we will be getting the result or not. That is the reason the current iPhones or otherwise any mobile phones, if you observe, there is no much change in the performance. Have you observed? Even iPhone also, simply they are changing the simple specifications only, not complete enhancement is not there. Yes, they are unable to move to the advanced level because already it is almost saturated. People are trying to develop some new devices. With the new devices only, they can develop new high performance processors. And this is one tool like HSPICE. We are having different, like almost 43 different MOS transistor models. Okay, level 1, level 2, like that. Okay, this is a never ending task because people try to develop new devices. For new devices, we try to develop the new model files. Those model files we will be keeping in the library. Okay, then whenever we need, suppose if we want to develop an inverter, means we take the MOSFET from the library and we connect them, we give the input, we try to observe the output. Okay. And this is an example of simple MOSFET model file. Okay. You can observe. You can observe here, this is like M name means MOSFET name, drain, gate, source and substrate, because this is a 4 terminal device, and MOSFET model name, this L means channel length.